justice will be brought before men. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we decided to take that pause with the inevitable journey to address this issue of sincerity because it's so important. And it concerns me because of the narration of the hadith of yesterday that some of you will be turned off from doing righteous deeds, being concerned that you're showing off. Here is before the break, we explained the origin of sincerity and showing off and hypocrisy and all of this. And also the view of the eminent scholar Ibn Rajab rahimahullah regarding the deeds and their status. Let's take this time left from the episode today and talk about how can we develop sincerity. Step number one, you must confess and admit that you are subject to showing off. If you think that you're not subject to showing off, then we have a problem. You must recognize the problem. Akhi, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, every day, he used to make this dua, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an ushrika bika wa ana a'lam wa astaghfiruka lima la a'lam. Aw kama qala sallallahu alayhi wasallam, O Allah, I seek refuge with you to commit shirk knowingly and forgive me for committing shirk unknowingly. Ibrahim al-Khalil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about him in the Quran. Ma kana Ibrahim yahudiyan wala nasraniya. Ibrahim alayhi salam was not a Jew nor a Christian. Walakin kana hanifa muslima. And he was hanif Muslim. Wa ma kana min al-mushrikeen. Ibrahim alayhi salam, the one whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was commanded to follow. Thumma awhayna ilayka an ittaba' millata Ibrahim hanifa. What did he say? Wajnubni wa baniya an na'bud al-asnam. Ya Allah, he's afraid to worship idols. So you think now you're spared from, look, this hadith. Who was addressed by this hadith? Abu Bakr, Umar ibn al-Khattab, Uthman ibn Affan, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abu Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah, Talha ibn Ubaidillah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressing the companions and the hadith fi Muslim al-Imam Ahmad, hadith Mahmud ibn al-Labid, radiyallahu an, inna akhwafa ma akhafu alaykum al-shirk wal-khafi. The one thing that I fear most on you is the hidden shirk, which is a riyah, showing off. Huh? So you cannot walk in out there and say, no, I'm a hypocrite. No, I'm not a hypocrite. Akhi, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman, radiyallahu anhu, the secret keeper of the Prophet, the one who kept the secrets of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his way back from the Battle of Tabuk, the names of the hypocrite in Medina, the name of the hypocrites. Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu, The one whom Allah revealed Quran matching his words, the one whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if there are prophets after me, it would have been you, Umar. The one whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لو سلك الشيطان فجا, if Shaitan meets you, Umar, Shaitan will escape. He went to Hudayfa ibn al-Yaman, Ya Hudayfa billahi alayk, my name is written there. Ya Allah, Hudayfa tells him, no, and this is the last time I'm going to reveal a secret. ولا أزكي أحدا بعدك أبدا. Abu al-Aliya, one of the predecessors, he said, I met 30 of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. They were fearing this. So you cannot live with the motion that you are spared from this. This is number one. Number two, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you sincerity. You see, only Allah will grant that to you. Because you need to understand this. Sincerity is the act of the heart. Now, if your heart is not in your hand, how can you develop sincerity there? Your heart, the king of your body, and this is the this is really the one thing that if we just ponder and contemplate about, the king of your body is not in your heart. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna quluba bani adama. Hadith Sahih Muslim, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. The hearts of the children of Adam are between two fingers of the fingers of Allah. He rotates them. Now, the one who can cause that heart to be sincere is Rabbul Alameen. So now you have to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is step number two. You need, oh Allah, Allahumma rzuqni al-ikhlas. Allahumma rzuqni al-ikhlas. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from showing off. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you new from hypocrisy. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من النفاق، أعوذ بك من الرياء، أعوذ بك من الشرك الخفي. You need to supplicate. You need to ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to bestow upon you sincerity and to keep your heart away from showing off and from hypocrisy and from shirk. Two, three, the knowledge of the consequences of shirk. يعني of the consequences of showing off. In the dunya, you end up working for nothing. Can you imagine someone who spent, that person spent his life in the battlefield for the people? Huh? You end up working for nothing. In the day of resurrection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hadith في مسند الإمام أحمد, hadith محمود بن لبيد, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call those who committed shirk, go to the partners whom you committed these deeds for, get your reward from them. اذهبوا لشركائكم, go. You did not do this deed for me. You did it for another question. So this is in the dunya that you end up wasting your life, wasting your money, wasting your time for the people. And in the hereafter, you will end up losing the deed that you did because nobody will be rewarding you for it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you the reward. Now, understanding, why are you showing off for the people? Do you think the people can benefit you without Allah's permission? You are mistaken. في سنن الترمذي حديث عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما. He said, one day I was riding with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and here's what الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم told عبد الله بن عباس while he was a little boy. احفظ الله يحفظك. Be mindful of Allah. Allah will be mindful of you. احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. If you are mindful of Allah, you will find Allah سبحانه وتعالى always helping. Listen. وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. If you seek help, seek Allah. وإذا سألت فاسأل الله. If you ask, ask Allah. Hear this. واعلم. And be informed. Be sure. That if all of mankind gather to benefit you with something, they will not benefit you with something but that which Allah decreed. And if all mankind gather to harm you with something, they will not harm you, but with something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed upon you. Look at the end of the hadith. رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامِ Pens are lifted. وَجَفَّتُ الصُّحُفُ And the ink is dried. Why? Because this is already written, أخي. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ مَقَادِيرَ الْخَلَائِقِ 50,000 years قَبْلَ أَنْ يَخْلُقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ أَخْرَجَهُ مُسْلِمُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote the provision of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 50,000 years before he created heavens and earth. Hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As fi sahih al-Imam Muslim. So you think now by showing off to people are going to benefit you or harm you without Allah's permission, you have to fix that. You have to change that. Akhi, no one can harm you. No one can benefit you but with Allah's permission. Now, you want the people to like you? Akhi, sister, no. Rest assured that you will not be able to get people to like you all the time. Everybody to agree with you. This is a fact. If there is someone who deserves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who deserves to be liked by everybody, would have been Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If there is someone who would have deserved to be liked by people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ You have the best character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of everybody, praised the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But yet, they called him a magician. They called him a liar and all type of things. You will not be able to please people. Rest assured. And after all, you know, the hearts of people is in the hand of the one that you're disobeying. You're showing up for somebody in order for this person to like you. You know, his heart is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, if you do what you do sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will direct the heart of this person to like you. Because his heart, as I mentioned earlier, is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is where Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah made that statement, قَلْبُ مَنْ تُرَائِي بِيَدِ مَنْ عَصَيْتِ The heart of the person that you're showing off for is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Akhi, if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get people to like you, all what you have to do, I mean people here, the believers, the disbelievers and the hypocrites will never like you. All what you have to do is be sincere and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will direct people to like you and to love you. But I want you to live with the fact that no way you're going to get everyone to like you. Yani there is another out there, I'm not sure quite frankly if it is authenticity, but it's written in one of the Israelites that Prophet Musa alayhi salam one day asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh Allah, We know that Prophet Musa alayhi salam spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, can you do something for me? What it is, oh Musa? Prophet Musa said, can you make people speak good about me all the time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Prophet Musa, I did not do this for myself. I'll do it for you. Ya Allah. People say that Allah has a son. Allah they cannot create, recreate, fashion people. So if you're going to worry about pleasing people, akhi, forget about it. Forget about it. And if you do this at the expense of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told you, hadith Aisha radiallahu anha, the hadith in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Man arda an-nasa bisakhatillah, askhat Allahu alayhi an-nas. Ya Allah, if you try to make somebody happy, like your boss, for example, you know he does not like Islam, and then you're working there and they, okay, I'm not going to pray because if I'm going to make my boss unhappy if I pray, if I show him my Islam, your boss will be firing you soon. Because you're trying to please your boss at the expense of who? At the expense of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ أَرْضَ النَّاسَ بِسَخَطِ اللَّهِ أَسْخَطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Wallahi, if you try to please someone at the expense of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make that person that you're trying to please angry with you. Look at this. وَمَنْ أَرْضَ اللَّهَ بِسَخَطِ النَّاسِ. And if you end up pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the expense of making somebody upset, rest assured that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn the heart of that person to like you, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice you. كَفَاهُ اللَّهُ النَّاسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice you from that person. So here is how you go about it. And akhi, what goodness is there if you are praised by people and you're on the side of Allah, you're despicable. Worry about pleasing Allah. Worry about making Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleased with you. These are all tools that can help you develop sincerity in your heart, which is a requirement in the deeds. Inshallah, the next episode, بإذن الله تعالى, we're going to continue on unfolding the scenes of reckoning. Do you know, brothers and sisters in Islam, after standing for too long and after all these events of the day of resurrection, the day of gathering, the day of reckoning, the first thing that you will be asked about? أول ما يسأل عنه العبد يوم القيامة الصلاة. Ya Allah. Not only this. فإن صلحت صلح سائر عمله. The first thing that you will be asked in the day of resurrection about is your salah, the five daily prayers. And if it is good, then we're going to look into the rest of your deeds. وإن فسدت فسد صالح فسد سائر عمله. The rest of his deeds will not be accepted. What's going on with your salah? Let's talk about this, inshallah. How are we going to be asked about our salah? And how important it is now to start paying attention to our salah. Remember, the inevitable journey is a means for us to start working. Brothers and sisters in Islam, till the next episode of The Inevitable Journey. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The scale of justice will be brought before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan. What you did in the open and what you concealed. From big to small shall today your deed.